क्लास 9 बायोलॉजी। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? हाउ ऑल आर फाइन? ओके। टुडे अगेन वी विल कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर द फ्लावर। टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस दैट फ्लावर कंटेन वेरियस पार्ट्स एंड पार्ट्स आर सेपल्स पेटल्स स्टामेन कार्पेल। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द डिस्कशन अबाउट द नॉन एसेंशियल पार्ट दैट आर सेपल्स एंड पेटल्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टू मेन रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स दैट आर स्टामेन्स एंड द कार्पेल्स। Stamens collectively known as androecium and are the male part, whereas carpels are the female part. Clear all of you? So one by one we'll discuss stamen and carnosium. Stamens are the main part or the male part that consist of anther and a stalk, long stalk known as filament. So this is the stamen. The stamen are the male part that consist of anther and filament. So androecium, stamens. The number of stamens in different flower may vary from a few to a large number. Each stamen consists of a long filament and an anther attached to its extremity. The anther is usually two-lobed. Each lobe has two pollen sacs. Within the pollen sacs are contained pollen grains. When fully can mature, the pollen sac rupture to liberate pollen grain. The pollen grains are generally powdery particles of different shapes and size. Here this anther is a bilobed structure, means it consists of two lobes. So these are the two lobes. Each lobe contains two pollen sacs. So altogether one anther which consists of two lobes and each lobe contains two pollen sac. So altogether a single anther consists of four pollen sac. Clear all of you? Once more, anthers are present at the extremity of long filament. Anther is the male part that consists of two lobes. Each lobe consists of two pollen sacs. So altogether a single anther contains four pollen sacs. Each pollen sac contains powdery particles called pollen grains. When these anther rupture after maturation, pollen grains release into the air so that it transferred with the help of air, water as well as insect to the female part, so called stigma. Clear all of you? Okay. Now come to the next. In androecium, stamens may be pre-polyandrous as in petunia or joined and organized in single, double or several groups. So in androecium, stamens may be pre or in several organized groups. Clear all of you? once more androecium that consists of stamens may be free or organized in groups. If it is free, if all the stamens are free, such androecium is known as polyandrous. Such stamens are known as polyandrous when all the stamens are free from each other. Like this, if it is female part, then all the androceums are free, all the stamens are free. Such stamens are known as polyandrous. Now come to about the groups. If it is found in organized group, then the groups may be organized into single, double, or in several groups. These groups, stamens, organized into single group, double group, or several group. If it is organized in single group, it is known as monoadelphous. If it is organized in double group, it is known as diadelphous. And if it is organized in several groups, it is known as polyadelphous. Clear all of you? Once more, androecium that consists of stamens. Stamens are organized either in free form, means all the stamens are free. Such stamens are known as polyandrous. And if it is organized in several groups, then the groups may be organized in single, double, or several. Single organized group is known as monoadelphous. Double organized group is known as diadelphous. And if it is organized in several group, it is known as polyadelphous. See the figure. It is organized in single group. It is organized in two groups. And it is organized in several groups. So organized in several group, polyadelphous. Two groups, diadelphous. And if it is in single, it is known as monoadelphous. See the figure here. It is monoadelphous, diadelphous, and polyadelphous. See, stamens are united in one group by their filaments. Only anthers are free. Example, China rose, cotton, etc. Second, diadelphous, the filaments are united in two bundles. Example, pea. Out of 10, 9 stamens form a staminal tube while one is free. And in polyadelphous, the filaments are united in several groups. Example, bombyx. Now come to the last part, that is carpel, collectively known as gynoecium, or this is the female part. Clear all of you? So gynoecium is also known as pistil. It is composed of one or more carpels. Each carpels consists of three parts: stigma, style, and ovary. Stigma is a terminal lobe like part. It may be divided into two or more lobes and may assume a feathery appearance. The stigma is covered with hair or with glandular papilla. It serves as the landing platform or place for pollen during pollination. Style, second part of the carpel. Tubular cylinder stalk which connects the stigma to the ovary. And third, ovary, the solid vessel part composed of one or many carpels fused together. The inner cavity of the ovary may be single chamber or divided into several chamber locules, each containing number of rounded body, the ovules, present attached ovules to the wall of the ovary. Gynoecium is also known as pistil. It consists of one or many carpel. Each carpel consists of three parts. Stigma, style, and ovary. Ovary contains ovule. So, stigma is the terminal knob-like structure, may be divided into two or more lobes. It may assume a feathery appearance, feather-like appearance, as well as it contains several papilla, glandular papilla that secrete sticky substance. Why? When pollen grains seed over the stigma, it prevents the falling of pollen grains. Its feathery appearance as well as its secretory nature prevent the falling of pollen grains from the stigma to the outside. Style. Long slender tube and ovary is the swollen basal part that contains one or more carpel. The ovule is the innermost part which contain inside the ovary. Now this ovary which contain ovule attached with the inner cavity of the ovary. So ovule that contain inside the ovary is attached with the inner wall of ovary by stalk, and this stalk is known as placenta. So placenta is a ridge-like structure that connects the wall of the ovary, inner wall of the ovary, with the ovule. Clear all of you? Once more, gynoecium, also known as pistil, consists of carpel. A carpel consists of three parts: stigma, style, and ovary. Ovary contain ovule. Here this is the ovule and this is the ovary, and the inner wall of the ovary attached by ovule by structure, ridge-like structure known as placenta. Now, come to the new topic, inflorescence and placentation. So, what is inflorescence? It is the arrangement of flower on the floral axis, or as it written in your book, it is the mode of arrangement of flower on the axis of a plant. See, one figure of two figures are given here. See, this is a particular arrangement of flower. One grew at the terminal part of the branches and other it arises from the axil of the leaves. So this particular arrangement of flower is called inflorescence. Once more, just see both these figures and see the pattern of arrangement of flower on the figure. Here in first figure, flowers arise at the terminal part of each branch. Here on the other figure, the flowers grow at the axil of the leaves. Means it is the arrangement of flower on the floral axis. Clear all of you? Okay. Now, placentation. We have studied that ovary contains various lobes or locule, and each locule the ovary attached. So I have drawn three figures, and each figure the arrangement of ovules is different, and this arrangement of ovule with the wall of the ovary is known as placentation. Clear all of you? So this is the end of the chapter. Clear all of you? Now I am giving you some homework. Take care. Later all of you must do that homework. Clear all of you? Okay. Bye to everyone and have a good day.